Good morning. Our time is maybe now 1 minute before 10 o'clock South African time, one minute before 3 o'clock Indonesian time. Good morning. What a privilege for me, Pastor Niels Foster, to spend time with you in the Word of God, being in the Word. You know, today we can say many things, but at the end it's the Word that's the truth, not the revelations of people. Not everything must be tested to the Word of God. We have so many people saying so many things today and interpret so many ways the Scripture, and many of those people will say, but I have a revelation, I have a Rhema word. But if it's not tested by the Word, it's not true, because a half-truth is still a lie. And I believe this is the time where really, yes, many people maybe mean for good to encourage people, but many people is just trying to mislead people. The fact is, Jesus, hello Popo, the fact is, hello Wilson, the fact is, God is who He says He is. Doesn't matter what we're going through. And I'm so excited about this, let's call it a series about Mark, the book of Mark, chapter 16, verse 17 and 18. This is really an amazing revelation that God has placed, you know, in the Bible for us to understand. And understand, Jesus was saying this just before He was ascended to the Father. Hello, Grace. Good morning or good afternoon. I think you're in Hong Kong, eh? God bless you. Yes. So in Mark 16, verse 17 and 18, just before Jesus left, He gave His disciples, they had to go out and they had to preach the gospel. And then just before He left, because we read in verse 19, He then ascended. But in verse 17, we read the following, and He said, these signs shall follow them that believe. In My name shall they cast out devils, they shall speak with new tongues, they shall take up serpents, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. It's like promise upon promise, and confirmation about confirmation. So when God sent you out, He said, if you believe, these signs will accompany you. So I was speaking on Friday regarding the first part of, hello my darling wife, I was talking about the first part of this scripture in Mark chapter 16 verse 17, and my focus was, and these signs shall follow them that believe. So and the word the signs was actually described in the Greek was the official written notice that announced the final verdict. It's like Jesus said, listen guys, I sent you out. Girls, I sent you out. This is My final verdict. This is My final, Pastor John. This is the final verdict of the court. This is the final decision. I will send you out. I'm going to the Father now. I will equip you. So that word signs that will follow us, the word sign actually mean, it's a signature or a seal applied to a document to guarantee the authentical and signed it marked by the location of the city. So actually Jesus was saying these signs were to be the signature of God. And this is this series about the signature. What does it mean? God approval. And I don't want to preach what I already preached on Friday. I want to go to the next phase. You know, to the next, because He listed a couple of things in verse 17 and 18. What is the signs that will follow people? But one thing that stood out about this is, when we preach the gospel, it means for those who believe, and that word believe was continuously, not just believe whenever you're in a problem, whenever you have a situation, but when you continually have and believe. And the major part of this scripture is, if you have an expectation of God to show up. So whenever you preach the gospel, there's a signature, there's a seal, there's a confirmation that God will answer what you've preached. The gospel, He will manifest what He said supernaturally. That's why when many times you have evangelists and they preach the gospel, you will see the blind eye open, you will see the deaf ear open, they will hear again, the lame will walk. Why? Because that's the signature, it's the seal, it's the final verdict to prove that God is the true God. He is the one authenticate your message that you're preaching. Now he bring in the practical, the supernatural to confirm what you were preaching. So I was preaching on that on Friday. And then he said, these signs, what is these signs? What is this signature? What is this that he said you will accomplish? The first thing, you will cast out devils. You will speak with new tongues. You will take up serpents. If drink any deadly poison, it will not hurt you. They will lay hands on the sick and the sick will be recovered. So also the ones, like I've said, I don't want to preach on what Friday. You can go back and you can listen to that message. I want to go on and I want to go to the next one, to the first sign that actually speak about this. Amen. Also, just to bring that also in, if you read in Mark 16 verse 20, so Jesus was not just telling the disciples. It was not an empty promise. He really said, listen guys, if you believe, these signs will follow, meaning the supernatural will follow the gospel that you preach. The supernatural, why? Because that's the seal, that's the signature that God said, I approve of the word you're preaching about Jesus Christ, who died for you, who paid for you, and his grace is enough for you. But just to show you that I am who I am, I will heal the sick. I will do this. And this is the huge thing. Whenever we preach the gospel, we need to have an expectation continually. Not just at time, continually have an expectation that God will show up. God will prove the message. If we preach about the supernatural, God will show up. God will prove that he is who he is. Amen. So in Mark 16 verse 20, it says actually, and they went out and preached everywhere. Remember verse 19 said, and Jesus ascended. Now they turn around and they start preaching. They really took Jesus on his word and they went out. They took it as a seal, as a signature, as an authentic message that if I preach the gospel, something miraculous will happen. Why? Because the sinner need to see the supernatural of God. The sinner need to see that Jesus is the one, the true and only God. Amen. And he confirms the message by the supernatural. So in verse 20 it says, and they went out and preached everywhere while the Lord kept working with them. And this is amazing. God is working with you, my friend. I'm talking to evangelists. I'm talking to the fivefold ministry, to many preachers. I'm talking to the individual in the marketplace where you're just sharing the gospel, maybe to a colleague or a family member. Listen, you're not alone. God is working and he will keep on working with you. You're not alone because he is there. Why? Because he said, Jesus said, for those who believe, this will follow, meaning I put my stamp, my signature. I will prove to the world, to the unbelievers, that my gospel is the truth and that I've bought them, you know, through my blood and through my death. It's grace. Amen. So, and then said, the Lord kept working with them and confirming the message by attesting signs and miracles that closely accompanied them. My friend, if your message is without these signs, you must ask yourself, because God wants to prove the message as true. But today we have so many messages. But how do we know it's true? Because firstly, the Bible is the thing that must authenticate the word we speak. We have so many ideas about COVID-19. We have so many, why does Christians get COVID-19 and some not? Well, maybe that's something I will talk in the future about. But listen, for some people, they will get into a dungeon like Paul and Silas, like I preached yesterday. But there, it was the supernatural to shake, worship shake literally the foundation, worship bring down the house, but the jailer and his family got saved. Sometimes, you know, God will bring you into a place because somebody else needs to be saved. Amen. So even COVID-19 can bring you to the hospital so that people can see Jesus, and it's an opportunity for you to minister. But what happened? We look at ourselves and we're feeling sorry for ourselves and we're sick, and you just look outward. and see where you can preach the gospel. Because verse 20 said, Jesus will keep on working with you. You're never alone. If you trust God, He will come and He will authenticate the message. Amen. So let's get today, to the first sign. They shall cast out devils. So the ones who continue to believe and have an expectation, the sign, the authentic seal and last, let's say, a declaration of Jesus says that this will happen. I will prove the message. So what happened? The first one, the sign, they shall cast out devils, and these signs shall follow them that believe in my name, they shall cast out devils. So what do we do when we confronted with a demonic infestation in someone's life? You know, I always say, because the question, who can basically, I don't want to say, my word will not be good, who can cast out devils? Let's just stop for a moment. Well, actually, every born again believer that is blood washed has the authority through the blood of Jesus, because Revelation 12:11 says we have the victory through the blood of Jesus and through our testimony. Jesus already overcome the devil. He already won. All right. So when you accept Jesus, actually Christ in you is the one casting out the devil. Why? Because the devil is confronted by the blood and what happened on Calvary and by the resurrection. The moment you come into somebody that's demonic, you don't need to shout, and you don't even need to have an argument. You just need to, if you know your identity in Christ, and this is what Jesus said, you just tell them. Jesus never confronted or had a long conversation and a fight with any demon. He never had. He just said, listen, go. You just go. But what happened? The demon recognized him even before he spoke. And this is what Jesus was telling. The signature, the authentication is once you come across somebody that's demonic oppressed, to cast out the demon, you don't need to put up a show. You don't need to do a lot of stuff. You know, because the demon will see Jesus inside of you, and he will see the signature, and he will see the final declaration, like what has happened. And when you open your mouth and you speak from your heart, why? Because what you believe is, you believe that Jesus already overcome the devil. You just speak to that devil and say, you're not, be gone in Jesus' name. You know what? He must leave. Why? He is submissive under the authentication what Jesus already gave to the disciples. So, and this is what he said. Amen. So, what happens if we are confronted? Like I've said, actually every believer, even if you've just been born again today, are already in a place to cast out demons. But the problem is, we don't know our identity. We don't know what Mark 16:17 is, because we struggle to continue believe, struggle to have an expectation, and we do not understand the sign, the signature, the authentication that God wants to set someone free that is oppressed. It's not a battle. It's about open your mouth, and by the power of the Holy Spirit and the blood of Jesus, just be out in Jesus' name. If it's a demonic entity of sickness, a spirit of infirmity. So Acts chapter 10 verse 38 says, and Jesus went around the whole country, and everybody that was oppressed by a spirit of sickness or infirmity cast out. You know, we have all of these strange things. We have this battle around somebody's bed, and we bind the devil, and we try to shout him out, and we try to convince him. You know what? In Mark 16 say, if you believe, my signature will follow what you say. If you say, devil, in the name of Jesus, I remind you of what happened on Calvary. You're already defeated. You must leave in Jesus' name. You have to leave. Amen. So we take authority over it in the Jesus' name and cast it out. That's that. It's not a big thing. Amen. So in Mark 16:7, Jesus, in my shall they cast out devils. Now this word cast out actually in the Greek means to throw out, as to evict someone from a place, to drive out or to expel. So, hello Anil. So what happens is you need to expel just the devil. He doesn't need to be in that house anymore. Because the blood of Jesus is against whatever there is. Amen. So what it means to cast out, when Jesus said, and not in his name, so you come in his name and you expel the demon in somebody's life. That's that. And you know what? If the demon said, I have a legal right, then you say, you know, for those who believe, the sign. The sign says Jesus is the final verdict of the court. Already said, demon, you are evicted. You must go. I remind you of this. And you must go. Why? Because this is the highest letter, the final letter that the court said, you cannot stay in that body anymore. Amen. If I want to evict somebody out of the house, I just need a court letter that's saying, you know what, get out. Now, this is what Mark 16:70 says. For those who believe, this is the letter. You just remind and show the letter. What is the letter? An expectation, continue of belief in the letter that you have. God is the one that authenticate the word if you said, get out in Jesus' name. Why? Because in his name, you will cast them out. Amen. But today we tend to think of casting out demons in terms of ordering a demon spirit to leave a person's body or mind. Certainly, this is one aspect of casting out demons, and we need to be quick to take authority over demons. In this way, we recognize the activity. You see, if we look at some examples of Jesus, I mean, he just said, you know, just go. Just go. You can read in Matthew chapter 8, verse 16. Alright, it tells us that Jesus literally kicked out these demons out of people's lives. In Matthew 9:34, even when the Pharisees acknowledged Jesus' authority over demon spirits, it says, but the Pharisee said, he cast out devils. This word cast out also is from the same word that when Jesus said, you will cast out demons. The same principle, the same thing. What does he say? Evict them out of somebody's house. They cannot longer stay there. They like parasite. They like illegal aliens in somebody's house. And by the authority God has given you and me as the believer, you have the written signature and seal authentication. If you believe in Jesus, and if you continue to believe and expect that he give you that right, you will just tell the demon to go. And guess what? He will go. But I'm telling you, actually something extra. The demon will recognize Jesus in you even before you speak. He will even tell you, listen, I will go. But you know, because we do not understand the word, we do not understand the authority of the word and us as believers, guess what? The devil, the demons is playing, just playing with us. Because why? We do not understand what we have. We do not understand what was Jesus' last commands to his disciples. Amen. So we see in Mark chapter 67, it makes it very clear that casting out demons is a responsibility of every believer. Why? Because the person being oppressed by a demon is actually struggling to get free. So when you chase out the demon or cast it out, you actually help the person because that person is oppressed by that, being influenced by that. If it's sickness or just feeling sad or just feeling oppressed, always negative or whatever, you understand? It's just to set them free. I mean, Jesus wants you. Why? Once the demon left, that person also see the supernatural and see that the message when you spoke to the devil and it left, guess what? He see the authority and the anointing literally that God is here. He see the manifestation of the gospel. But if you preach to this guy and he leaves and he still got a demon, why should he turn to become a Christian? Because you didn't set him free. He's still the same. He's still under the same authority of that demonic entity. Doesn't matter why and how he got there. The fact is, if it comes across your path, Jesus said to the disciples, if you believe, cast them out. Set the people free so they can come to Christ. Because I will work with you, chasing out that demon, so that the person can believe that I am who I am. Amen. You understand that? So, but when they appear, we are to act in as Jesus would act, taking authority over them and kicking them out of people's lives. This setting people free from demonic control. Amen. Demons are also considered to be the chief force behind occultism, sorcery, witchcraft, and paganism. So whenever people are involved in these things, the chances are 100% that they can be demonized. Amen. Now the question is, can a Christian be demonized? Well, he can. Because it lies in the soul dimension. Because when the spirit is reborn, it's only the spirit that's reborn. But that's something I will talk about maybe some other time. Because we understand, because we're in a progress of salvation and God is setting us free. Amen. So what happened in the pagan times, when people come, let's say, they come to the knowledge that, listen, they were pagans and they were idolaters. What will happen? They will bring all of their books and charms and they will burn them. Although that time they didn't really have books, they had like papyrus rolls that was handwritten and it was worth a lot. So, but when they come to the conviction about their idol worship, let's say not believing, and when God touched them, you know what they do? The first thing, yes, the demon goes, but secondly, they get rid of anything that could attach them to whatever that demonic entity entered into them. So that's why when people brought stuff into the house and people allow certain stuff in their lives, they need to get rid of that. Just as, basically in the time of let's say, in the time of Jesus, but even up to now. You cannot have still a witchcraft altar in your house and you being set free and you think you will be free from demons. No, that's still a portal. That's still an opening. Even the books and the stuff, you need to get. So this is what happening. They actually came forward and they just burned their scrolls. They burn everything because they don't want anything to attach them. And that sometimes is important. We need to get rid of the things that maybe sort of draw us into the occult. You cannot still keep that. If you have the revelation that Jesus is the Son of God and He set you free, also you need to get rid of that. Amen. So once you take care of that, it means you cast out not just in the person itself, but also anything that's maybe related to that. Amen. So yeah. So when you think about casting out demons, don't only think about taking authority over a yelling, screaming demon, ordering it to leave an individual. Part of casting out demons is also removing anything associated with magical arts, incantations, spells, or any activity or items related to it. Amen. So this is really important that we need to understand it. So the first one, the sign, you will cast out demons. So what you need to understand today is the following. You have the authority. You have the signature. Tomorrow I will, or on Wednesday, I will start speaking on the next one. You shall speak in new tongues. But I want to conclude today just with the following. Coming back, for those who let me just get to the scripture so I can just quote it correctly. Amen. So it says that in the King James, and these signs shall follow them that believe. So if you believe in Jesus Christ, these signs that you can cast out demons will follow you. Why? Because it's the signature, it's the official written notice that whatever is in somebody's life, you can evict. Amen. And verse 20, Jesus worked with the disciples. And wherever they got people that's been demonized, they just evict the demon out of the person. It's not really a big thing. Why? Because the demon is reminded by the blood of Jesus. He is reminded his time is few. He is reminded that he already is defeated. It's not about you. It's not about how spiritual you are. It's only about, do you continue to believe who you are in Christ Jesus? Because it's the supernatural, Jesus through His Holy Spirit, that does the authentication of the message. When you speak to someone that's maybe demonic and you said, be out, it's the Spirit of God that moved that that demon will leave. Amen. If I can maybe just give it another angle. It's like David, he had to swing the sling with a rock. But when he opened it and he slinged the rock, it's actually the Holy Spirit guiding the projectile to the forehead of Goliath. So the supernatural worked with the natural, but there was something in the natural that had to be done. And this is where you and I had to do something. If you believe and have an expectation, the sign of the devil that will leave, will leave. If it's sickness, there's many. I mean, maybe on some time we can speak about the different types of demons that Jesus did expel to understand what types there are. But the fact is, you know, on your word, it's not to give the devil anything. You know what? Jesus already defeated him. It's not even an equal battle. It's not even a battle. It's just a question of open up your mouth and in his name tell the demon to go. And it must go. Because it sees already its defeat. It's already sees the signature of the Father and already sees that it has to be evacuated. And then it must go. That's really just that. And that's why any believer is supposed to have that authority. Because we have that in Christ Jesus. Amen. So Wednesday I will carry on speaking in tongues. I will look at all five. But the series is about one thing. Know who you are. Know that God has placed the signature upon you. He has given you and me the authority. And you are not alone. He is there with you and he worked with you. Even you feel it's just the devil telling you, nothing will happen. It's not what you can do. Even it's screaming, it's not what you can do. Only thing that you can do is continue believe, trust God, have an expectation, remind the devil about the seal of God, and you will see that God will expel. Amen. Let me pray for you. Heavenly Father, I thank you for today's message. I thank you for the ones that hear. Lord, equip them, especially people working in the evangelistic area. Father, where they will come into people in, you know, that's being pagans and have different idols that they worship. And the fact is, they've allowed these idols in their lives. But Lord, you have given us, for those who believe, a sign that the devil will go. The demons will be casting out. And already, it's already being authenticated. You will authenticate the word we speak. And therefore, I just pray for everybody. Cover us with your blood. That's so important. That we need to understand the name of Jesus. That we need to understand our authority. And in that, you will just work. And thank you, Holy Spirit, for being there. That we never alone. Never alone. Even sometimes when we feel alone. But we never alone. And thank you, God. Bless everybody. Bless them in this week. And be excited about the Word of God. Excited to be alive in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for watching. May God just bless you in this week. Amen.